question asked in the previous gate examination. The given question is from a subject, industrial engineering, and the topic is linear programming. So the question goes like this. A furniture manufacturer produces chairs and tables. The woodworking department is capable of producing 200 chairs or 100 tables or any proportionate combinations of these per week. The weekly demand for chairs and tables is limited to 150 and 80 units respectively. The profit from a chair is rupees 100 and that of from table is rupees 300. Now they are asking us to find, first question, set up the problem as a linear programming problem, and second question, determine the optimal mix for maximizing the profit, and the third question is, what is the maximum profit? Now it is a linear programming problem. Now they have given the question in terms of some statements, right? Now first of all, what we have to do is we have to convert these statements into the linear programming problem. That means from these statements we have to write the objective function and we have to write the constraints, and then we have to find the solution using graphical method, right? So first of all, we will try to formulate the problem from the given data. So to formulate a problem, we are just using the tabular method, okay? So tabular method, what we are doing? So there are chairs, right? And tables. So we are dividing these chairs and tables like this, right? Fine. Now again, we will go back to the question and we will see the question. So the woodworking department is capable of producing 200 chairs or 100 tables. So as of now, we will leave this statement and we will try to see the other constraints, right? So the weekly demand for the chairs and tables is limited to 150 units and 80 units. So say for example, there are x1 number of chairs and the x2 number of tables. So we are having two variables here, okay? Now the weekly demand for chairs, okay, and tables are given. So this side we are writing the resources, okay. Now this side we will be writing the RHS values, which are the limitations for those resources, right? Now here they are saying, so they can manufacture chairs only 150 and they can manufacture tables 80. Fine. Now what they are saying from this, what is the understanding? So they can manufacture only 150 chairs, in the sense, so number of chairs is x1. So now x1 into 1 less than or equal to 150. Now the next constraint will be, they can manufacture only 80 tables, in the sense your x2 into 1 will be less than or equal to 80 tables. So 80 or less than or equal to 80 tables they can produce. So this is their limitation, okay? Now coming back to the objective function. So they are saying that they are making a profit of 100 rupees from chairs and 300 rupees from the tables, right? Now this will be our objective function. So x1 will be the number of chairs, so this will be the unit profit. So this will be the profit per chair and this will be the profit per table. So if you multiply it with number of tables, okay, say 100 into x1 plus 300 into x2, you will get the total profit on tables and chairs. Fine. Now coming back to the first constraint, right? So first constraint is some woodworking department. Okay, so now they are saying that the woodworking department is capable of producing 200 chairs or 100 tables. That means we have to convert this statement into a constraint like this one, right? Now can we write like this, 200 chairs equal to 100 tables, Now the meaning of this statement here is the time taken for manufacturing or producing 200 chairs will be equal to time taken for producing 100 tables. Fine. Now they have given this statement. We have taken this statement into the time taken values, right? So we have to convert this statement into a constraint. So we are assuming the time as a constraint, right? Now 200 chairs is equal to 100 tables. Now we can find the ratio chairs by tables equal to 100 by 200, which will be 1 by 2. Now again the meaning of here is, say for example, if a chair is taking 1 hour time, table will take 2 hours of time. Fine. Now this is the meaning from here. Okay. Now this we have to convert into a constraint. Now say for example, if your chair is taking 1 hour of time, your tables will take 2 hours of time. Okay. Now as we have taken the reference value as chairs, right? Your RHS will be in terms of chairs, which will be 200. Okay. Now the reference here is chairs. So time taken for manufacturing one chair will be 1 hour. Then the time taken for manufacturing one table will be 2 hours. Now we are having only 200 hours of time. So this is the meaning of this constraint. Say for example, you can take vice versa also. Say for example, if the time taken for manufacturing one table is 1 hour, okay? Now you are taking the reference as tables, okay? So this is our reference, fine? Now say for example, time taken for manufacturing one table is 1 hour, right? Then the time taken for manufacturing one chair will be half an hour from this equation, right? Now as you have taken the reference as tables, right? Now it will be 100 tables. So both of these statements will give us the same constraint. Fine. Now we will write the objective function and we will write the constraints. Now our objective function will be z. As it is a profit, this will be a maximization function. Z max is equal to 100x1 plus 300x2. Now subjected to the constraints. So our first constraint will be x1 plus 2x2. x1 plus 2x2 less than or equal to 200. Or we can write the same constraint as half x1 plus x2 less than or equal to 200. So both of these constraints are same, okay? Both of these constraints will give us the, this will be 100, sorry. So both of these constraints will be same. Okay. Now the next constraint will be x1 less than or equal to 150. Now the other constraint will be x2 less than or equal to 80. Now the non-negativity restrictions are x1 comma x2 greater than or equal to 0. Now we got a formulation of the problem, right? We got the objective function, we got the constraints. Now let's draw these constraints in a graph. Say for example, this will be our x1, this is our x2. So similarly, we can take either of the constraints because both are the same. So if x1 equal to 0, your x2 will be 200. If x2 equal to 0, so this will be 100. If x2 equal to 0, x1 will be 200. Fine. Now this will be x1 equal to 150 and this will be x2 equal to 80. Right. Now let's plot these constraints in this particular graph. So first one will be 0, 100. Say for example, 0, 100 will be somewhere here. So 0, 100. Now the next point is 200, 0. Now join these two points. Right? So now this is a less than or equal type constraint. So your region will be towards the origin. Fine. Now the next constraint will be x1 equal to 150. So say for example, this will be 150 comma 0 point. So this will be a straight line parallel to the y-axis, which is x2. So this will be x1 equal to 150. Now the next constraint is x2 equal to 80. So maybe somewhere here, 0 comma 80. So this x2 will be 80. Now again, these two constraints are of less than or equal to type. So our feasible region or region of interest will be towards the origin. Okay. So now this will be our feasible region. So this will be our feasible region. Now we got a feasible region, right? So first question was to formulate this into a mathematical problem. Second question, okay, we have to find the optimal mix, right? So optimal mix in the sense, the point at which we will be getting the maximum profit, right? And the third question is to find the maximum profit itself. Fine. So to find that, we have to evaluate the objective function value at all the corner points of this feasible region. So I am naming these as A, B, C and D. Right. Now we have to evaluate the objective function. Our objective function is 100x1 plus 300x2. Right. So objective function value at 0 comma 0 will be 0, right? Now the objective function value, this is at point O. So at point A, our objective function value is Z 0 comma 80. So this will be 24,000. Now at point B, our objective function value will be, so now if you solve these two straight line equations, you will get this point as 40 comma 80. Fine. And you will get this point as 150 comma 25. So just by solving these two equations, we will get these two points, right? So now at point B, it will be 40 comma 80. This will be 28,000. Now at point C, your Z value is 150 comma 25 is the point. So Z value will be 22,500. And at point D, Z value is 150 comma 0. So Z value will be 15,000. Right? Now among all these values, as the given function is a maximization function, so maximum value is this one. Okay, maximum value is this one. So our answer for question number 3 is 28,000, and now our answer for question number 2 is 40 comma 80. So they are asking the optimal mix, right? So that means the x1 and x2 values they are asking. So your x1 value is 40 and your x2 value is 80. So at this point, at this particular point, you are getting a maximum value, which is 28,000 rupees, right? So coming to the options, coming to the questions. So question number A, set up the problem as a linear programming problem. So we have found the linear programming problem from the given data, right? Now question number B, determine the optimal mix for maximizing the profit. So now our optimal mix will be 40 comma 80. That means, so for question B, 40 comma 80 is the answer, right? This will be the answer for question A, this will be the answer for question B, and for question C, they are asking us what will be the maximum profit. So at this point, we will get the maximum profit, which will be 28,000. So now 28,000 rupees is the answer for this question number C. So thank you.